Good morning, folks. I'm the Minister of Municipal and Northern Relations and Indigenous Economic Development. I am proud to represent municipalities across all of Manitoba, including the fine community of Lac du Bonnet. I would like to take the opportunity to acknowledge that I am speaking on Treaty 1 territory and the homeland of the Métis Nation. I also wish to acknowledge that Manitoba is located on the original lands of the Ojibwe, Cree, Oji-Cree, Dakota, Dene, Métis, and Inuit peoples. We respect the treaties that were made on reconciliation and collaboration. And I must say it's great to be out here in the community of Lac du Bonnet, stopping over at Drifters, Grant's Bake Shop, my friend Curtis dancing down the road. It's great to be out here today. We're here today for a very exciting, long-awaited, and major announcement. Without further hesitation, I would like to introduce you to you, the Premier of Manitoba, Sir Rob Kinew.
Well, as somebody who grew up in a small community, I know how difficult it is to keep a secret. I gotta say the amazing turnout here today is maybe a good reminder of that. One thing that I actually did find a little surprising is, you know, folks wondering like, oh, you know, what's it all about? Is it good news or bad news? So let me just cut straight to the chase and just say it is good news. We are here to announce construction of a personal care home for Lac du Bonnet for real this time.
Wow.
We got to get you out more often. That's great. I would like to thank everyone in the community and in the region for your patience. This is something that's been a long time coming. I know the initial announcement was made some 12 years ago, and the work I know has begun even longer ago than that. And that's why I said for real this time. We're not here to announce a commitment or a plan or feasibility. We're here to say there will be shovels in the ground this year. So I'm gonna invite my colleague, the Minister of Health, up to walk us through some of the details of the good news here, but I just wanted to talk about the importance of this. Clearly, this is important to Lac du Bonnet. Clearly, this is important to the whole region. So many folks from across the Eastman region here today. I want to thank you all for driving out and for taking time. And speaking to people, even just a few minutes that we had before the announcement began, we heard stories about why this is needed so that we can have good quality care close to home. And I want to say that it's needed for the region, for sure, but this is needed provincially. Our whole province is short of long-term care beds. And that's having a big impact on seniors, a big impact on families, but it's also having an impact on our hospitals. And so this investment is needed in order for us to be able to improve healthcare here, but also right across Manitoba. And for me, one of the big lessons of COVID, and believe you me, like everyone else, I want to put COVID in the rearview mirror. I don't want to revisit the pandemic. But think of all the sacrifices we made over the last few years. The birthday parties, the Christmas celebrations, the get-togethers that we gave up. The memories that we should have been able to make with one another that we sacrificed in order to get through that period together. To me, to make good on all that sacrifice means that we had to learn the lessons of that experience, of the pandemic. And seniors care and the responsibility of us collectively as a province of Manitoba to do better by our seniors, to me, is one of the most crucial, fundamental lessons of the pandemic. All the time are the fact that, listen, when we're talking seniors, we're talking about the people who taught us, the people who served us meals, the people who fought in the wars to protect our freedom and democracy, the people who literally built the society that we know and love today. And it seems to me that we have a basic duty, responsibility, and obligation to do right by that generation who are there for us in our time of need when they approach their time of need as well. And so this commitment to this personal care home and the others that we're going to build over the next 4 years is an investment in health care. It's an investment in seniors care. But most importantly, it's these generations of Manitobans stepping up and fulfilling our responsibility to you, the greatest generation. So with that, I want to thank you all for joining us here today, and I want to introduce your Minister of Health, Uzoma Asagwara.
Thank you so much, Premier. Very powerful words. Good morning to everyone. I've had the chance in our few minutes leading up to this announcement to meet some of you here today. I'm so happy to be here. I'm so pleased to be here amongst all of you. Met someone who said she's been working on this for 30 years. Another person, 20 years. We're talking about decades of commitment that has gone into this moment becoming a reality. I'm honored to be here with all of you. This day is long overdue. And so it is my absolute pleasure to announce that Lac du Bonnet will soon be home to a 95-bed personal care home. 95-bed personal care home. As a result of investments we will be making in our upcoming, soon coming budget, construction will begin as soon as possible, with the aim of this personal care home opening in 2027, so very soon. It is a privilege, and it's been an absolute privilege in our first few months of government to speak directly to you folks, to hear directly from you, to folks pulling me aside at AMM gatherings and making sure they're putting that bug in my ear. It's been an absolute pleasure to hear from folks from surrounding communities about what this personal care home is going to mean to them, about the importance of knowing that if and when the time comes, that seniors here will have a place to call home. And that is so important. For folks to know that the care that they deserve will be waiting for them in their own community, close to family and friends and circles that they've cultivated in many cases over generations. That their grandkids will be close at hand and able to visit and connect to watch over them. And if your family is anything like mine, maybe you'll spoil those grandkids a little bit. Maybe a lot, maybe too much to some people, but that connection is so important. And so today is a reflection of our commitment as a listening government to work together with communities throughout our province to make healthcare better in Manitoba. To make sure that all Manitobans, no matter where you live, can age with dignity. I want to recognize again the incredibly hard work of community leaders, community members who have worked so hard to make this a reality. Folks have advocated, you've written letters, you've phoned offices, you've again pulled people aside when you have the opportunity. You have fundraised a lot of money. I know there's a lot of work that you're looking forward to continuing to working with our government to do, to keep moving this along as quickly as possible. But thank you for all of your hard work. And now I'm pleased to introduce the mayor of Lac du Bonnet, Ken Lodge, to share a few words with you folks. Thanks.
Good morning, everybody. I'm showing up here this morning with basically an unprepared speech, but the first thing I need to do is I need to extend an apology to Premier Kinew and Minister Asagwara for approaching them at the AMM convention, and for Premier Kinew, because I approached him a couple of times at the Métis AGA before he became Premier to sort of light the fire. And I approached him again at the AMM, so my apologies for doing that. Wasn't 100% sure of the protocol. Nonetheless, I want to take the opportunity to thank everybody for coming here today. You, the citizens of our region, are the ones that this work is being accomplished for. This has been a long time in coming. I want to thank everybody that's had a hand in this development, this plan, this dream that we've had for in excess of 20 years. Personally, I've attended two sod turnings. At that rate, it would take about 10,000 years for me to dig the foundation for this building. So I certainly appreciate the input of the Premier and Minister Asagwara, because it would have been a long job. And I don't know if I'll live that long, but I'm going to work on it. Now, the most important part is this thank you that I'm offering to the Premier and the Minister, as well as the government, is somehow more strongly felt than the thank yous that I had previously offered up for the development of this facility. It is so heartfelt, I can't even really come up with the words for this. There's a lot of people who have left us in the intervening time where they could have reaped the benefit of having this facility here. We've done the best we could do up to this point, but it's extremely important that we plan for the future. This takes major steps to support us in our endeavors in the future, in our community, and in our region. So I would like everybody to take the opportunity now to applaud the present government, as well as the efforts of the past government, to make sure that this facility gets built here, regardless of what the potential ramifications were before, the disputes that were before. We're here now to celebrate. This is very important. This is for you. Think to the future. The past is done. Thank you.
Well, good morning, everyone. Premier Kinew, Minister Asagwara, Minister Bushie, Reeves, mayors, councillors, friends, family, and our seniors. It's not difficult to put into words the thank yous here, but Premier Kinew, and thank you for bringing such a positive announcement to our community. It's been a long journey, 25 plus years. You know, community volunteers came together with a vision back then, a new personal care home. Some of these people are here today. I won't point them out, but some of them are here today that started this journey back then. Others have passed away, unfortunately, but they're here in our memories. There's been countless hours of volunteerism, so many people to thank. In 2017, we refreshed the personal care home plan. We formed a working group here, former Mayor Gordon Peters, David Thursberg from Graham Construction, FD3 Architectural. We worked with Interlake Eastern Regional Health Authority. Marion Ellis is here today. We submitted a new plan and a proposal. We kept the PCH dream alive. We kept it alive for our seniors. Thanks to all the mayors, Reeves, the councillors, some are here today. The residents of the Eastern Regional Municipal Health Committee are here today. Their unwavering commitment and support for this project. Community leaders who all recognize the need for this, and it's been reiterated here this morning. A very special thanks to the Lac du Bonnet Heritage Committee, the interim CAO, Gordon Peters, to the dedicated community members, that board of directors that has worked extremely hard behind the scenes, updating costs, finalizing plans, working with IERHA, working with provincial assistants to move this forward, provincial officials, working with the former RMLA here today, working with them to get the plans moving forward. Ian Baird, who is the consultant hired by the former government to move this forward. Without that commitment and that dedication, we wouldn't be here today. Back in 2012, when the Premier talked about this, it's kind of ironic that Premier Seliger came here to our community, and that was the first sod turning.
You bet.
I wasn't there for that, but I have the shovel from the second one, Mr. Premier. And I didn't bring it here today because I thought this was going to be a positive announcement. So, but ironically, here we are 12 years later. And it seems rather fitting that Premier Kinew, Minister Asagwara, and your provincial team is here to pick up this announcement, to make this important announcement. And in my view, essentially pick up the torch for caring for our seniors. Thank you, Mr. Premier. From all of us here today, in closing, Premier Kinew, we thank you and your government for committing to build a better home for the seniors who built this region, our great province. Now, let's get the shovels in the ground and finally move this project forward. Thank you all for being here today. God bless everyone. Miigwech.
Sorry, Pat Forth, I'm sorry.
All right, so I think we have one other speaker, right? Absolutely.
Pat,
do you want to introduce Pat Forth? Yeah.
Sorry.
I got so excited, I can't believe this is actually happening. We have someone that's worked in the healthcare field here and is so committed to our seniors on a daily basis. And I was asked by the lead team here to come up with someone that can speak from the heart. And I know Pat's heart is with the seniors in the room here today. So I'd like to, it's my honor and privilege to introduce Pat Porth to come forward and say a few words. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. Good morning, Premier and Honourable Minister and guests. I guess a lot that I'm going to have to speak about is going to sound like a broken record because it's a hard act to follow of the Premier. But thank you for coming to visit Lac du Bonnet in eastern Manitoba. You kind of think that maybe the government has forgotten about us. And yes, I'm one of those people as well who has been involved in some form of the 20 years plus of the personal care home being in progress. So today it is wonderful to be part of this announcement. I'm very passionate about my seniors and I try to do whatever I can within my guidelines. And it's really nice to know that when now once people age out of home, like the big buzzword is aging in place, well, we have a lot of people who have now have aged out of their place. And it's pretty dire. And once home care and our services seniors program can no longer provide services to keep them in their home as long as possible, they now will have a new home, a new residence, and be allowed again to remain in their community amongst friends and family. And like I say, I can't say enough about how thankful I am to hear this announcement. And I will certainly continue to work with whoever requires assistance, wherever it may be, small or large, in order to make sure that this project moves forward. So thank you again for coming out with this announcement and remembering Eastman. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Pat, for your words and for your work over many years. Now I'd like to open it up to media for any questions.
Good morning. Everybody hear me? I'm Rick McGregor from the Lac du Bonnet Clipper, the local newspaper here. I guess the first question, and Premier Kinew did state that this was for real this time, but can we say that this is written in stone, carved in stone, and carved in Manitoba granite?
Yeah, it's happening. It's happening. And, you know, this is something that, as the Premier stated, it's maybe in smaller communities, all communities, it's Manitoba, hard to keep a secret. But this has been a priority for our government from the get-go, and it's important for folks to know that our commitment is making sure that we are building personal care homes in Manitoba for seniors and for Manitoba families who depend on that. And so we were very excited and very excited to be here today, looking forward to continuing to work with the community to make sure that this, as the Premier stated, shovels in the ground work is being done this year.
Okay. At the last sod turning and that Mayor Lodge referred to, we were told that the funding was in place, the previous government, that cabinet had approved it, finance department had approved it. What's different this time?
It's a new day in Manitoba. It's a new government in Manitoba. We are committed to following through on our commitments to Manitobans. We know that health care is the top priority for Manitobans across this province. We know that seniors who built this province have had some pretty extreme challenges in recent years and deserve to have a government they can count on delivering on their commitments. And so this is another step our government is taking to make sure that Manitobans and folks living in Lac du Bonnet know that they are a priority, that we're eager to work with you to make sure that projects are completed. And beyond that, we're going to continue to build more personal care homes in Manitoba so that seniors can have a place to live when, as Pat said very, very well, they've aged out of their place in their homes and community.
Okay, thank you. One last question. What, in a statement or a couple of statements, how would you sum up the NDP's government's overall approach to healthcare in Manitoba?
Sure, I'll offer a couple of remarks and then I'll invite the Premier up as well. Our approach to healthcare is putting people first. Our approach to healthcare in Manitoba is to recognize that we are one province, we are one people, and that no matter where you live, you deserve to have access to quality health care close to home. People come first, which is why we started our mandate in government by sending an open letter to healthcare workers across the province to let them know that they have a government that wants to listen to them, learn from them, work with them, and that respects them, you know, to reset the relationship with healthcare workers. We immediately began investing in strengthening healthcare here at home, in our own province. Up to share his thoughts on that as well.
Thank you.
Yeah. I think universal access to public healthcare is a fundamental Canadian value. This is one of the things that makes our country unique from our good friends and neighbors to the south. And as a result, I think that improving healthcare, fixing healthcare, investing in healthcare is one of the great things that we all agree on to build this province into the future that we want together. I know that, talking about the pandemic started with us all going outside and banging pots and pans for one another, and it ended with us yelling at each other. I think we all want to put that in the rearview mirror. We all want to turn the page. We don't want to be divided. We want reasons to be united as one people, one province that is sharing one future. And I firmly believe, you know what, we don't agree on everything, but healthcare, I think that's something that we all agree on. And so investments like this, investments in hospitals, investments in rural doctors and seniors care across the province, this is stuff that everybody agrees we need to get done. And so I believe in delivering healthcare to people, but I also believe in investing in healthcare as a way to bring people together right across Manitoba.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay, I'm getting the sign that we're going to Zoom now.
Thank you, Premier. We have a couple of questions on Zoom today.
Another thing we could leave in the pandemic.
We'll give a chance for a couple of reporters on the line. First up, we have Radio Canada, Carolyn.
Hi. I have a question for Prime Minister Kinew. Could you please, pourriez-vous s'il vous plaît en français faire l'annonce de la nouvelle d'aujourd'hui au lac de Bonnet, s'il vous plaît?
Oui, nous sommes aujourd'hui pour annoncer un nouvel foyer pour la soin des aînés. Et puis, c'est une vérité cette fois-ci. La construction va commencer cette année et puis c'est toujours important d'avoir l'appui des communautés ici dans l'est de notre province, mais c'est toujours important pour nous comme le gouvernement du Manitoba pour appuyer les aînés et puis tout le monde qui ont besoin de soins comme ceci.
Merci beaucoup. Et j'aimerais aussi vous demander le budget, quel sera le budget de construction de ce centre? Et est-ce qu'il y a eu un changement du budget depuis celui qui était initialement proposé par le précédent gouvernement?
Je pense que c'est quasiment la même chose de la dernière fois. La chose qui est différente est que ce gouvernement va le construire. Et puis le niveau du budget, c'est à peu près 66 millions de dollars. Et puis ça va livrer 95 lits pour soigner pour les aînés et pour tous qui ont besoin de cette sorte de soins.
Merci beaucoup.
Final question from Zoom is to the Free Press, Katie.
Hi there, thanks for taking our questions. To the Premier, this was one of several capital health projects that were put on hold late last year, including other potential personal care home projects. Can you say how many other personal care home projects are still on hold, and has that review been completed?
What I would say is that our province has to live within our means, and we have to find a sustainable way to deliver that amazing vision of healthcare that I was talking about as a way to bring people together. And our province cannot sustain all the things that were announced in the lead up to the election. And so we've been doing the work to figure out how do we prioritize all these great projects, all these great ideas. And I can tell you in black and white, this personal care home
is in the budget that is going to be introduced to the people of Manitoba on April 2nd. And the answer to the rest of your question will come on April 2nd as well.
Okay, pivoting slightly, hoping that you can tell us more about what's happening now with the Imperial Oil pipeline shutdown.
I would say completely unrelated to personal care homes and healthcare. Anyway, sorry. Yeah.
Well, you said earlier this week that we shouldn't panic, we shouldn't worry about a shortage. Meanwhile, we're seeing some of the pumps have limited supply, some of the pumps are dried up, and people are starting to worry about a gasoline shortage. So do you have any update on what the situation is now?
Yes. First of all, I want to thank the people of Manitoba for being very responsible in terms of the situation that we're going to have to live with for the next few months. And I noticed some commentary in the media about saying that people shouldn't be hoarding gasoline. But what I would say today is that suppliers, there is a regular entry into the province of this 50,000 truck. But we also need to make sure that that supply is being distributed equitably across the different regions who need it, across the different sectors of the economy. We're heading into seeding season as well. But also to all the different retailers of fuel in our province. So we've communicated this directly to the oil and gas companies that you need to provide access to all.